So I'm Akshay M. I'm part of Ideal Lab here, and I'm working as a research assistant in FOSSI project. So I'm here to pitch an idea about OpenPLC, what we are working on, what we are planning to do in the coming months, and some requirements that we have a few positions to be filled as an intern. So I'll also give you the requirements at the end of this session. So I'm working on this project called OpenPLC. So you might have seen PLC or you might have heard of PLC, right? It's a programmable logic controller. So PLC is generally used for automating a task in industry. So it can be considered as a digital computer, right? It's a robust digital computer which can perform multiple tasks. So it needs multiple inputs, right? And it should be robust, as in it should have extended temperature ranges for operation. It should be immune to electrical noise, as in it might the hardware might be subjected to a lot of electrical noise, and it has to be immune to that, and it has to be resistant to vibration and other physical stress as described in the standard which we follow. So we are currently following standards as proposed by IEC. So IEC has different verticals. So we follow IEC 61131 standard. So the standards give a specific tolerance limit to which the vibration physical test is allowed. So the hardware should work well within the constraints as given by the standards. So PLCs are used for automation and control. So automation is basically delegation of a human activity to machines to achieve some of the points which I mentioned in the slides. So it may be higher productivity, since most of these machines can work 24/7 in ideal conditions with very little maintenance. So automation can increase the productivity. Automation can give you a better product, end product, because you have more control over the manufacturing process. Then there is also the efficient use of energy and resources, and improved safety in working conditions. So automation is the future, and we are already seeing it, right? So you might have seen robots in action in manufacturing facilities, in automobile manufacturing sector, in pharmaceutical industry, right? So automation is the future, and we are trying to make a hardware which can perform this task, or which can ease the migration from a classical approach to an open PLC enabled or PLC enabled industry. So why PLC? So before PLCs, we had this classical control where we had relays, switches, right? So we had switches to give a voltage or to give a change, relays to control control a device. So the relay switch systems existed way before 1960s, and the problem with those systems was the poor scalability, the high on maintenance part, the fault detection, poor reliability. You must have seen, right? See, when you have a basic structure, basic switch relay circuits, the problem is that you cannot scale it beyond a limit. And when you scale it beyond the limit, what happens is you'll have breakdowns at some point. You might see a lot of issues in automating the task as such. Reusing the modules are not possible because these modules are hardwired, right? So there's a lot of issues involved when you have a switch and a kind of relay circuit. That's a very basic hardware control. So then we have the PLC. So PLC, what we have is a microcontroller controlling high voltage devices, right? Which is connected to a dedicated power supply, and it's also connected to a programming device. So you might have seen some PLCs made by Siemens or ABB, right? So how many of you have seen a PLC? Okay. So how many of you are electronics? How many of you have an electronics background? So very few people. Okay, so basically it's a computer, and it's a computer which have relays on one side for an output control, and isolated inputs for taking in voltages. So there'll also be power supply, dedicated power supply, because in PLCs the controller might operate in one voltage, whereas IOs might operate in another voltage, right? There might be other devices like an ADC or a DAC, which might operate in another voltage. So you might need a separate power supply module which can deliver these different power voltage rails. So that's a general PLC here. And then we move on to the programming part. So you have a hardware, right? You have a hardware which can be programmed. And you have several inputs and outputs which can be controlled. So PLC programming is done using, in IEC 61131 standard, we have five methods or five programming languages, of which three are graphical and two are textual. So ladder program, functional block diagram, and sequential function chart. So SFC, LD, and FPDs are graphical programming tools or graphical programming languages. So they have graphical programming tools to facilitate programming. So ladder, I have shown a ladder rung. I have about three rungs, no, four rungs here, right? So I have two main rungs, right? How many have programmed a ladder? Programmed in ladder? None, okay. So basically ladder programming is a very basic graphical way to program a relay. So you have some relay output, or this relay can be connected to a motor, okay. So you have switches. So you have switches which can be like normally on, normally closed, depending upon what you want. And so what happens is you have rungs, which means these are, one is input and one is output, or one may be the power rail and one is intended input stage. So we are connecting the two poles using a switch, and that switch is actually something which is implemented in the controller instead of having a hardware switch. Okay. So that is how ladder programming is done. And instead of having a real world switch, we have a virtual switch, and the logic is then converted into bytecode or the machine code, and then compiled to the controller. So then we have functional block diagram, structured text, instruction list, and SFC. These things, the structured text, instruction list, and sequential function charts are not being used these days. These days we have moved to, the industry has moved to ladder programming and functional blocks. So functional block, you might have seen functional block diagrams in action, even in normal programming methodologies. Like, for example, if you have used Node-RED or any graphical programming tools, there you have function blocks which perform a specific application, right? It might have an input function block, output function block, something, a rule generator or a rule function, right? So something like that. So that's a functional block diagram. Or the industry also use structured text. Structured text is something which forms a backend of the functional block diagram. So when you have something like a functional block, like an input stage, the input stage is actually realized using some structured text. Okay, that is how the standard is being used. Okay, this is what we have right now. We have a single board which can be used to do experiment on do a lift experiment, a heater and fan subsystem, or a traffic light experiment. So it's a single board which can be used to perform basic experiments in ladder. Okay, this is what we plan to achieve in the next 2 months. We are planning to make a hardware which is compatible with a runtime called Forte. The hardware should have support for CAN and Ethernet. It should have isolated 24-volt input-output ports and isolated ADCs. It should have support for add-on cards via serial peripheral interfaces, such as SPI, I2C. And so the software part, we are planning to develop application using function blocks in IEC 61499 standard, which is a relatively new standard. So we are trying to migrate, we are trying to support documents and hardware for that, so that industry can migrate from the IEC 61131 to IEC 61499. And in the software part, you'll also be exposed to setting up a headless plug and play module. And the activity context and policy aware IoT applications, and the legacy support for ladder. So we also should have support for the previous system. We cannot just randomly migrate to a new environment. So so what we plan to do is we'll migrate to the new environment, but still we'll keep the legacy support. So this is Open PLC version 2.0 technologies. So for the hardware, we'll be using KiCad for schematic and PCB, NGSpice for simulation. So all the hardware is planned to be released under OSL license. The current hardware will also be released under OSL license. Then open source software involved, LD Micro is a tool used to program or do programming in ladder. Then we have ODAC for function blocks. Eclipse SCADA will be used for the front end. The hardware, the target machine will be run on the Linux platform. So we'll only use GPL or LGPL or EPL licenses. So ODAC is based on EPL, whereas the Linux, the most of the code which is written in SCADA is actually in GPL. Whereas Eclipse SCADA, there are two forms of SCADA involved. So Eclipse SCADA will be EPL, and you can learn more about this in the website, from the website of ODAC or from OpenPRC website. Okay, so we need three passionate individuals who can contribute to the front end, who is an application developer, who can develop programs in ladder as well as function blocks, and he'll also be exposed to a few HMI interfaces, so like Eclipse SCADA, and he'll also be introduced to concepts of industrial IoT models, basic published subscriber models using MQTT and constrained application protocol. Then we'll also need a Linux developer who has really good bash skills and who is willing to learn more about network interfaces and some interfaces in C using C for SPI I2C, because we will need to, so most of the hardware is based around Linux. We still need a lot of we still need to put in a lot of effort in terms of driver development for the add-on cards. So we'll need people who can do that. Then hardware developer is someone who can take care of DC-DC designs, relay boards, breakout boards, basic designing using KiCad, and enclosure designing using any of the open source tools, like Cocopelli, Antimony, any of those, or even OpenSCAD. So this is the requirement. So if you're interested, you can write to me or you can contact my manager, or I don't know how it is being done. So yeah, you can contact the right person. You can also write to me, and if you have any questions, you can write to me. So any questions right now? No. Thank you.